Hello and welcome back to Bee Monster Laboratory. Today we're going to take a look at the IC Station LED Flashing Light DIY Soldering Kit. It's basically an LED star soldering practice kit with an acrylic shell. It's fairly cheap, but is it worth the money? Let's find out. I really enjoy doing projects like this, the soldering practice kits that I've bought on Amazon, and I just enjoy doing it, and it's not because of the outcome, but because I enjoy soldering, and I really, maybe I'm like you, I don't have a reason to do it very often yet, anyway, so I like to solder whenever I can, and I'll buy these, and I'll solder some, and it's excellent practice. So my soldering skills actually have improved quite a bit. I no longer see burn marks on the board. That used to be an issue. I don't see like connected contacts. It used to just be one big bubble. Those are beginner mistakes that you'll have. And, you know, some of them are kind of bubbly and some of them are just right on perfect. But I don't see any major issues with soldering. You know, they're not all perfect, but they're all good enough, it appears. So I do enjoy it in that aspect. And as you can see, this thing looks amazing whenever you put it in like a Christmas display or any other type of display. Anytime you add LEDs to something, it's just going to kick it up a notch in my opinion. And I love the LEDs that change color. This was ideal, but you know, there's a couple issues with it, and I'll go ahead and tell you what they are. I didn't test every LED, which I probably should have. Well, no, not probably. I should have. I should have tested every one of them and then used the 3 backup LED that they gave me in case one wasn't good. So the soldering part was actually pretty fun. The case was probably the most difficult part of it all. There's no clear instructions on how to put the case together. So it took me a few minutes to figure out that the side pieces actually have 2 grooves that go into the bottom here, and then 1 groove that goes into the front. And then you have to line them up correctly, and of course the one with the hole goes there. But so putting that on, I found that one of them was burnt, it looked burnt, and warped, which threw the whole thing off. So this hole right here didn't line up, so there's no screw in that part right there. Now, even if I could get that screw in there and it was lined up correctly, they gave me the right size screw but the wrong size nut. I don't know. Not a big deal because it's just the case is already sturdy. It's fine. But those are just a couple of flaws that I noticed in the product itself. So after I got it all together, I realized that this screw right here was not going down. And you can see it right here. The threading and this brass piece right here is jammed or something. It's not correct. I took the case apart. I checked the threading, and that's as far as it goes. So, I mean, I can make that work, but there are definitely some flaws with some of these pieces. It does look all right. I mean, when it's not turned on. And the case is pretty sturdy, even though it's got a couple flaws. And maybe the soldering is all my fault. I mean, it very well could be that some of the LEDs don't light up. And if you look at it, the bottom couple LEDs on the bottom right of the star, they don't blink ever. And the bottom left, the one on the bottom left doesn't blink. And then the one on the left at the tip of the star doesn't blink. So I'm not sure why that happens, but I mean, I don't know if you would notice that those are out if you're just walking by and you take a glance at it. Who knows? But I mean, it's okay. Not my best work, but yeah, I did enjoy the project. And I will buy another one in the future, maybe one from a domestic company like SparkFun or DigiKey or Electronics Express or Jameco. I've ordered from those guys before, and they all have solid products, so maybe I'll have better luck with one of their products. Another interesting thing about this this little build here is that there is a 4-pin piece right there that I put on the board, soldered it in. It looks like it's for jumper cables. I don't know exactly what it goes to, and the instruction manual doesn't say. But it looks like it could provide power somehow. I don't know. Well, that's all I've got for today. If you've done one of these kits, let us know how it went for you. Maybe you had some issues that we didn't have, or maybe you experienced the same thing that we did, or maybe it went perfectly for you. If so, that's awesome. As always, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it very much. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Follow the channel so you can catch our upcoming videos. And until next time, take care. I'll see you very soon.